You know, over the years, I've had a ton of you guys reach out to me asking me for tips on how to pass the hardest part of any hiring process. The drug screen. No, that wasn't it. The interview. And to help you do as well as you possibly can on that wonderful interview process, I'm going to give you a few tips so you can finally become a part of the Band-Aid box riding, red truck driving brotherhood that we all love being in. Number one's pretty self-explanatory. Practice. Practice as much as possible. You have Google at your fingertips. Google as many interview questions as possible and then have the most intimidating people in your life ask you those questions. Do you have a friend that just likes to stare at you in a really weird way and not acknowledge anything that you're actually saying and you're trying to figure out what's going on in their head? Use that guy. That guy's perfect. Because most likely during the interview process, if you're spouting off the best information that you possibly can, the best reaction that you're going to get from somebody is one of these. Mm-hmm. And your job in that moment is to not take it personally, because it's not that they don't like you, and it's not that they don't like what you're saying, but their job in that moment is to write down as much information as possible so they can make sure that you get a fair hiring process. Number two, dress as well as possible. Look, we know not everyone owns a suit and tie. I mean, we are firefighters. 90% of us are so broke that trying to get $5 out of someone for dinner is like pulling teeth. But walk in there with the best possible clothes that you have. If all you have is a white V-neck shirt, a pair of scruddy jeans and some boots, tuck your shirt in, wear a belt, and walk in that room with your head high and confidence. We know the difference between someone who is lazy and someone who utilized the best tools that they have in their toolbox. Number three, command respect when you walk in the room. I'm not saying be disrespectful, but when you walk in that room, you look at every man and woman directly in the eyes and greet them. And then if you're allowed, you walk over to each and every one of them and shake their hand. And don't you dare dead fish somebody's hand. You firmly shake their hand, look them directly in the eyes, and let them know that you're there for business. And then quickly get back to your seat because you still have to be interviewed. Number four, be memorable in a good way. Remember, depending on the size of the agency or department that you're applying for, there may be 1,000 other applicants for one position. So you need to separate yourself from all 999 other people. And by answering questions with the minimal amount of information, you ain't gonna do that. If they ask you how to check out your SCBA, describe every single O-ring and connection in that system so they think, man, this guy knows what he's doing. And for the love of God, if they ask you why you want to be a firefighter or EMT or paramedic with their agency or department, do not just say, it's because I want to save lives and make a difference in the world. Every other applicant is saying those exact words. Instead, why don't you tell them a random fact about the 5 stations that they have in their department or the amount of water rescues that they did last year and how you would love nothing more than to be a part of that exact team. And finally, it's okay to not get the job. I know it sucks, but it doesn't mean you're stupid. It doesn't mean you're incompetent that you can't do the job. All it really means is A, you need a little more practice interviewing, or B, there was someone a little more well-suited for the job than you. And it definitely doesn't mean that you should give up. In fact, you should go back to that department. You should ask them what you can do to interview better. You should find the people that interviewed you and get interviewing tips from them. Because I can promise you this, if you go back to that department or agency and bother them and help yourself improve on how to interview and show your face all over that place, the next time interviews come around and you walk in that room, one of those people are going to look at the other person and go, hey, that's the person that came back and asked us how to get better. They're going to remember you. Most likely, you've made that mark and you're probably going to get hired. Well, I hope these tips help you finally snatch up the job of your dreams and you can finally live out all those life-saving fantasies you got running around in your dome. Oh, and by the way, if you do become a firefighter, one last tip. Don't become one of those condiment hoarding fiends that eats up all the ketchup and never replaces it. Good luck.